Hi, welcome to the PZ Engineering channel. In this video, we are going to show how to design and simulate DC-DC buck boost converter using MATLAB Simulink software. Before we start with our simulation, I'd like to request please subscribe to the channel, comment and like the video. DC-DC buck converter is a DC-DC converter that steps up or step down the voltage from its input to the output, which means that the output of a DC-DC buck boost converter can either be greater or less than the input. This is our DC-DC buck boost converter equivalent circuit. Here we have battery as the input. You have a MOSFET here. Gate, you have our inductor, diode, capacitor, and resistor as the load. We'll be measuring the output voltage across this resistor, which means during the boost converter, the voltage across the resistor is greater than the input voltage from the battery. During the buck converter, the output or the voltage across the resistor is less than the input voltage. Here we have our equations that we use to calculate the parameters of our DC-DC buck and boost converter. The first equation is duty cycle, and the duty cycle is the one that influences the output voltage of our system. From 0 to 50 is for buck operation, and from 50 to 100 is for boost operation. Equation number 2, we use to calculate the minimum value of our inductor. This is the resistor and the duty cycle switching frequency. The equation number 3, we use to calculate our capacitor value, and if you wanna be more specific with the inductor current, we use this formula. This is our DC-DC buck and boost converter given circuit in MATLAB Simulink software. Here the parameters, we have a switching frequency of 20,000, you have period of 1/2 switching frequency, duty cycle value of 0.5, which is using duty cycle of 0.5, it gives you the V supply will be the same as the V out. We have a capacitor, the value of 100. We have inductor 100 to the power minus 6, and we have inductor 28 to the power minus 6. All of these values we got from the previous formulas. Here we have inductor in the circuit, our inductor. We have our capacitor circuit. We have our input is a DC bus voltage, DC source voltage, 15. MOSFET, we don't need to change anything here. Take it from there and put it there. You have our resistor as a load. We're using a value of 9. All of these parameters, you can get them from a library browser. Now let's build our closed loop control to monitor our DC-DC buck and boost converter. Come here. I've been using this program. You can just go straight to recent used. If you don't know how to use, you can come in and research each parameters. For me, I need a PID controller. Substrate, you'll need PW. Gain as well. Now let's build gain with the per unit. We'll start first with back mode. Now we need our V output. And the output of our PWM generator goes to the MOSFET. We'll start with a back operation. With the reference voltage, output voltage is 12. Let's open our PID. We'll put our PI to, yeah, we use PI. Here we use 1 minus e to the power minus 6. That is a value of 7. And then here, let's use a value of 0.54. We limit output, which is the duty cycle. The power duty cycle is from 0.1 to 0.99. I think it is okay. Then okay. PWM generator, here you have a period, and your reverse frequency is 20. 1 divided by 20,000 is 0.00005, which is 0 to the power minus 5. And here we use the same simple time that we use. Substitution here. Now we can simulate, we'll start with back operation. You have the input voltage 15 and the output voltage 12. Let's open and see. Our mean value is 12.02, which is plus or minus expected output voltage during the back operation. Then we can still change it. Let's try to maybe 10. See, as we see, we're still getting 10 plus or minus 10, and if we open, we'll see our mean value is 10.0504, which is according to our expected value. Now we can go to the, just change your simple stop time. Now we are simulating in a boost operation. Where am I going? Sorry. In a boost operation, you can come here as well, change the value. If our input is 15, we are expecting to get 18. Let me simulate. See our output. So our output is 18. We can still change to another value. We change to 20 and we still having customized 20. Thank you everyone. As like in this design and simulation of buck and boost converter using a closed loop control. This converter only supplies. This is not a bidirectional converter. In the next videos, we'll do the bidirectional converter. Please guys, be part of our family by subscribing to our channel, comment and like the video. Thank you so much.